Eating is a very big part of my vacations, and I just got back from one. And while I was thinking of making a video, my options were either I hide those extra pounds that I've gained, or I make a video and show you how to hide it in pictures. So let's talk about how to hide that muffin top that you've gained right around your waist. Welcome to Blush With Me. Muffin top sounds cute, but it does not look good at all. I want to take you a few steps ahead of the things that you may have seen or heard on how you can hide this fat in your midsection. In my next video, I will emphasize more on posing for pictures, on how you can pose to create an illusion of a slimmer waistline. But today, let's talk about a few clothing and dressing hacks that can actually make you look slimmer on your midsection. Let me first start with what you should not be doing. Do not wear any satin or anything shiny material, because that literally highlights and brings out every bulge and curve and fold in your body. You can actually get away wearing a tent, but with satin, there is nothing rescuing you. Tip number two, don't wear very fitted tops or clingy dresses, because obviously that will highlight your bulges on your waist. Another mistake people make is to wear very loose clothes to hide those few inches of fat around their waist. You don't need to do that, because see, what you're doing is, to hide those few inches around here, you are willing to look shapeless all over. Just a loose big top does nothing to your figure. It does not flatter. Even the strength that you may have get completely hidden under that loose top. So avoid wearing something that's very loose. Stay with me till the end, because in the end, I will explain the do's and don'ts about pants and body shapers and why not, and how to wear it. But for now, the next tip is, guys, you know what? I love wearing high-waist jeans. So go for a high-waist jeans. Low-waist jeans clinch your waist exactly where the muffin top begins, and it literally makes it ooze out. Wear a high-waisted jeans. It holds everything in together. Like today with this jacket, I'm wearing high-waist white pants, and what they do is they're holding my sides in completely, so I still look shapely. And then I'm wearing this double-breasted jacket, which is perfect. It creates layers one on top of the other and holds everything in. So this outfit is helping me create shape without showing any unpleasant bulges anywhere. Wearing long vests, duster jackets, trench coats, these are all other trendy ways of looking cute and at the same time hiding your waist. Peplum tops are great if you want your waistline to look narrow, and it creates the illusion of little wider hips and creates that nice curvaceous body. But if you team that up with a top that also creates the illusion of broader shoulders, imagine you're actually creating a perfect hourglass for yourself. After all, the whole idea is to dress the body you have to look like the body you want. Instead of wearing those shift dresses or straight dresses, try to wear empire dresses, which are kind of fitted till right underneath your bust line, and then they flare out a little bit. So it helps you hide that midsection. So all of us have different body types. Just like we look different, our bodies are very different. So that somebody's heavy on their bust, somebody's heavier on their waist, somebody's heavier on their hips, thighs. Everybody is different, so don't think that one trend works for the other person, so it should work for you. It may not, or it may. Sometimes those absolutely straight dresses look great on some people, but on some it just does not work. So what you could do is take the same dress, you want to wear it, it's trendy, so why not? But make a little change in it. Just tie a little belt right around the midsection so it clinches your waist, and at the same time you can wear the latest trendy outfit. Tank top is a basic. You need it under either that cardigan or the transparent top or that open button shirt look that you want to have today. How about you replace that tank top with a bodysuit? if you're like me and you do not want to take the Spanx route, you want to be comfortable and yet you want to have something that holds everything in place, trust me, if you think that bodysuits are for teenagers or young girls, until you try a bodysuit, you will not know what it is like to have your hands to yourself. You can do so many other things instead of pulling your tank top down all day long. Tank tops have a tendency to ride up very easily. You try to tuck in your pants or do whatever, they will ride up. And even if they stay where they are, because we have those curves on our waist, tank tops will show every bit of it. Bodysuit may not hold you in like a Spanx, but it'll really smooth everything out to look smooth all over. That's the idea. Body shapers, Spanx, spandex, girdles, call it whatever you want. They are great for certain occasions and it's true that they really hold you in. Everything looks a few sizes smaller once you have them on, but they hurt. You heard the word in my mind, didn't you? But Blush With Me always has a hack to help you. So this is what you can do. Instead of wearing your exact size, size it up. So if you are a small, wear a medium. If you're medium, buy a large. Doing this will not probably make you look two or three sizes smaller, but what this will do is smooth out all the folds on your waist, hence creating a nice smooth finish. The compression will not kill you and you will actually feel comfortable all day long. So usually if you wear your spandex very tight, it'll make you look smaller on your waist, but just where the waistband ends, you will notice a bulge right there. And the whole idea is to hide your flaws and not to create something that did not even exist before. So go ahead, what are you waiting for? Go and give these tips a shot. Try it out and let me know if these hacks worked for you. If you don't want your midsection or your muffin top to catch all the attention in pictures, then come back and learn how you can pose and just distract everyone completely away from your waistline and look perfect, just like you always do with Blush With Me. Take a sneak peek at some of these pictures and you will know what to expect next week when you come and join me on Blush With Me. Until then, do not forget to hit the subscribe button, guys. And don't forget my feel good factor, that comment. I want to hear from you. Do comment and do follow me on Instagram. I have two accounts. One is blushwithme_Parmita and the other one is Parmita Katkar Photo Factory. They are both completely different from each other. So go out and explore them for yourself and come back to me next week. Joining you every Thursday, Blush With Me. Thank you so much.